बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन, सेफ, हैप्पी एंड हेल्दी एट योर होम। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ साइंस ऑफ क्लास 3। बिफोर गोइंग इनटू द टुडेस लेक्चर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई इंट्रोड्यूस यू अबाउट योर साइंस बुक। दिस इज़ द टाइटल ऑफ योर साइंस बुक। Here, this is New Oxford Primary Science, 3rd edition. In the first term, we have included 4 chapters from this book. The first unit, the human body. The second unit is health and safety. Unit 3 is living on earth. Unit 4 is not included in this term. And then unit 5, the life cycle of the plant. So the 4 units are included in the first term syllabus. Now please open your books and open unit number 1, the human body. Students, before going into the detail of today's lecture, you must recall your previous knowledge. Students, you know and you have studied in the previous class that the human body is made up of many body parts, and each body part has its own function, like our eyes and ears, nose, our hand, our foot. They all are bent for a function. They all have its own job. Like eyes has the function to see things, nose can smell the things, your tongue is for the taste. The students, there are all the organs which you can see them easily, like your eyes, ears and nose. You can touch them easily, you can see them easily. They are called external organs. जो आपकी बॉडी के जिन हिस्सों को आप टच कर सकते हैं इजीली, दे आर कॉल्ड एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स, द आउटसाइड ऑर्गन्स। बट दोज देयर आर सर्टन बॉडी पार्ट्स विच आर इनसाइड द बॉडी, वी कैन नॉट सी देम, बट दे आर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द बॉडी। दे आर कॉल्ड इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स, लाइक योर ब्रेन, योर हार्ट, योर लंग्स, योर स्टमक। You also know that there are certain organs which are responsible to give information to the body about the surroundings. Such organs are called sense organs, like eyes, nose, ears, skin, and your tongue. So today we are going to discuss 2 topics. The first one, the human brain, and the second, we will study about the sense organs. The human body is like a machine, and you know every machine has to do the work. It's the ability of a machine to do work. In the same way, in the human body, the ability to do work is done by the organs. As you have studied that every organ has its own function. And when the organs which are doing similar function, those organs which are performing the same function, similar kind of function, they group together and they form the system. So in this way, our body is having many systems. Although you have studied that every part of the body is having its own function, लेकिन कुछ ऐसे organs हो जाते हैं जिनका काम जो है वो similar होता है, तो वो मिलके एक group बना देते हैं, which is called the system. So the organs and the system perform different functions, but they work together. Look at this picture. In this picture, you can see the children are running to play a game. So question is, which system is being used here? In the previous classes, you have studied the bones and the muscles are the organs, and they are involved in the movement of the body. So we can say that as the children are running here, so the muscular system and the skeletal system are being used here. Now the human brain. brain is the control center of the body. You have studied earlier that it is the boss of the body, that it controls all the activities of the body. Although it is making its own system, the brain is also having its own system, but it is also controlling all the other systems of the body. So it is controlling all the functions of the body. Here is the structure of human brain. The human brain has been divided into three main parts. The first one is called the cerebrum, and the second is the, this is the cerebrum, and the second part is the cerebellum, and the third part is the medulla. All the maximum activities of the brain are under the control of the larger portion of the brain that is called the cerebrum. Whatever we are learning from our surrounding, what we are memorizing, all is under the control of cerebrum. Whatever we are thinking about the future, about the past, about the present, it is also under the control of cerebrum. Cerebrum is also responsible for controlling all the senses, all the sense activities, what we are seeing, whatever we are watching, whatever we are listening, whatever we are sensing from the environment, what we are tasting, that all is under the control of cerebrum. So it is the largest part of the brain and controls all the activities, maximum activities of the body. Then comes to the cerebellum. It is the second part of the brain, and it is responsible for the movement of the body because it is controlling the muscles, and the muscles are responsible for controlling the movement of the body. Running, jumping, walking, all is under the control of cerebellum. When we are doing exercise, it is under the control of our cerebellum. Then come to the third part of the brain, that is called the medulla. Medulla controls all those activities which are not under our control, which are not taking our order. We cannot control the activities of heart. हम ये नहीं कह सकते heart को कि आज तुम अपना काम बंद कर दो. It has to do its job. We cannot control the activity of stomach in the same way as the activity of kidneys and the lungs. They has to do their job. They are not under the control. They are not taking any order, and their activities are controlled by the medulla. So medulla is actually controlling all those activities which are not under our control. Students, keep in mind that brain contains 73% of water. You should drink plenty of water for thinking, learning, and working properly. Plenty means too much amount of water, as it's hot these days, so you must take 6 to 8 or more than 6 to 8 glass of water in a day. Now move to the second part of today's lecture, that is sense organs. There are 5 sense organs: eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. They tell us, in the previous classes you have studied that these sense organs are responsible to tell us that what is happening in our surrounding. Now in today we will discuss much more about this. Okay, see, the first sense organ, that is eyes. When I see something, they send the information to the brain, and the brain then tells you what you are seeing. Jo bhi aap kuch dekhte hain, then from the environment, this information is taken by the eyes, and eyes send this information to the brain, and then the brain tells you what you are seeing. Right now you are watching the screen of the computer, your eyes are sending this information to the brain, and the brain will tell you that you are watching the screen of computer. Okay, second sense organ, ears. Ears send information like the eyes are doing. They are taking the information of sound, like you are listening the lecture. This information is taken by your ears to the brain. आप भी जो आप सुन रहे हैं यहाँ से, ये आपके ईयर जो इन्फॉर्मेशन लेके जा रहे हैं ये आपके ब्रेन को, एंड देन द योर ब्रेन विल टेल यू दैट यू आर लिसनिंग दीज वर्ड्स, एंड दिस दीज ईयर्स आर ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल, दे आर हेल्पिंग अस इन हियरिंग, एंड दे आर ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द बैलेंस ऑफ द बॉडी. ये जो हम सीधे खड़े रहते हैं, वी आर इन द स्ट्रेट पोस्चर, इन द स्ट्रेट पोजिशन, इन अ बैलेंस पोजिशन, दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द ईयर्स. Nose has the nerves which send the information to the information about the smell to the brain. हमारी nose में there are certain kind of nerves are present which are the part of the brain. Nerves are the part of the brain. And when there is a smell in the air, either it is an odor, which is odor means bad smell or unpleasant smell, or either there is a pleasant smell or a scented smell, खुशबू हो अगर होगी, the air that comes to the nose, it is taken by the nerves which are present in the nose and then sent to the brain, and then the brain will tell us that what you have smell, either you have smell this the pleasant smell or you are having a bad smell. Now the tongue helps you to taste the things and to talk, and it also covered with by small pores, chote chote suraakh hote hain, that tells how the food is, that is it is the salty food, it is the sweet food, or it is sour or bitter food, right? Then comes the skin. Skin helps us to feel cold, hot, hard and soft. हमारी skin हमें बताएगी कि what the thing is, what is the nature of the thing, either in the surrounding is the cold environment or the hot environment, or the thing or the pot or the liquid is cold or hot, either the thing or object is hard or soft. Your skin will process it. Skin will send the information to the brain, and the brain will tell us the kind of thing, that either it is cold or hot and hard and soft. The nature of the thing, nature of the objects will be taken or will be processed by the skin. Skin, beta, skin has nerves. Skin के अंदर जो हैं वो nerves होती हैं which are again the part of the brain which get this information from the environment and then send it to the brain, and then brain will tell us about the nature of the thing, right? That what we are feeling. So here is the overview of all the sense organs. There are five sense organs: eyes, which are responsible to differentiate between light and dark. Then we have ears, which help us in hearing, sound hearing and balance of the body. Then we have nose, which helps us in smell. Then there is the tongue, which helps us to differentiate the food, that either it is salty or sweet or sour or of sweet taste. And then here is the skin, the fifth sense organ, which is responsible to tell us about the touch, which thing has touched us, our skin will tell us what kind of pressure has been exerted to our skin. Kis tarah koi na koi cheez ne pressure to nahi dala hua, wo bhi hame skin hi batayegi. And then the temperature, either it is hot or cold. This all will be done by these all activities will be done by these sense organs. Hope the lecture is clear to you. Listen it carefully, read the text carefully, and then try to check yourself and try to answer the following questions. here are some questions. You have to try to find the answer of these questions, right? Like, which sense organs are involved? The first is this: you have to tell which sense organ is involved in this activity. The first, sudden changes in the temperature while you are sleeping. Second, when a pin prick your finger. जब कोई पिन आपकी prick means चुभ जाती है, किसी आपकी फिंगर को अगर चुभ जाए while you are searching something in your bag. And the third one, when someone comes from the front door, then which sense organs will tell you. So you have to find the answer of these questions. Do it and inshallah we will discuss them in our next lecture. Thank you so much. If you have any question, you can ask them in the comment box. We will facilitate you. Allah Hafiz.